Welcome to AskSanskrit.com, lesson 13. In lesson 12, we looked at present participles, active and middle, of thematic verbs. In this lesson, lesson 13, we will look at past passive participles and past active participles. We have encountered the past passive participle many times in our stories. It is very commonly used in classical Sanskrit to make sentences. For example, in the Hitopadesha story, The Brahmin and His Jar, in lesson 11, we saw the sentence with the use of the word prapta, which is pra plus apta. Apta here is a past passive participle of the class 5 root ap, as we explained in the lesson. In classical Sanskrit, it is common to say by him was got instead of he got when rendering sentences. This was got is what is rendered by the past passive participle apta. Some other examples of the past passive participle are given here. The past passive participle is formed by adding one of ta, ita, or na to the unstrengthened root. The formation of the past passive participle is very, very complicated. First of all, when the ta is added to the root, consonant sandhis apply. Secondly, many verbs undergo modifications like adding of nasal, dropping of nasal, samprasarana, weakening of a to e, weakening of and an to a, etc. Some examples are given here. All class 10 roots form their past passive participle with ita. It uses the same verb stem to which the personal endings are added for conjugation. Some other roots also form the past passive participle with ita. Here they use the unstrengthened root. Examples are given here. Some roots form their past passive participle with na. Examples are given here. It is used like the English past passive participle in ed or en, like obtained, stolen, etc. The past passive participle is declined like a ending masculines and neuters and a ending feminines. Three important usages of the past passive participle are given here. Note that the past passive participle can have an active sense in verbs like gum and other verbs of motion, gen and some others. The past passive participle occurs very often in the three Hitopadesha stories in lessons 4, 8 and 11. Please go through these lessons to get a full understanding of how the past passive participle is used. Like the present participle, the past passive participle can be negated by the prefix a or an before a vowel. Examples are anagata, not come, achorita, not stolen, etc. The past active participle, masculine and neuter, is formed by adding vant, and the feminine is formed by adding vati to the past passive participle. We saw the past active participle in the Hitopadesha story, The Brahmin and His Jar, in lesson 11. The word anagatavati is a past active participle. Note that there is no equivalent in English to the past active participle. Common usages of the past active participle are given here. Like the past passive participle, the past active participle can also be negated by the prefixing of a or an before a vowel, as we saw in the word anagatavati. This is the end of lesson 13. In this lesson, we looked at past passive participles and past active participles.